profit monetizing your domain name portfolio, we're going to introduce your moderator, and then each of the panelists are going to introduce themselves up here on stage. So we'd love to have everyone join us here, but Dr. Gregg McNair.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's really cool to be back here with this ever-changing facet of our industry, the monetization, and with the three giants of the monetization space as we know it. Michael Riedl from CentralNic, the CEO, Dan Warmuz from above, and Christian, what's your second name?
Voss.
From Sedo, the well-known face to all of us. Please, let's be seated. So, I guess each of us have come a journey since the last meeting here, and others in between perhaps, where we've seen some, I guess, movement in prices for the PPC and also on any of the zero-click platforms or even affiliate platforms that we may choose to use. But there's been some other changes in monetization that's impacted many of us in the space, and particularly these three gentlemen here, and that's the non-organic and referred traffic. And so we're going to try and touch on both parts of the space today, and I think the what I'd like to do is just ask each of these guys to give a bit of an update from their own experience of where we're at in the industry. And then we'll sort of go a little deeper into some of the facets of this topic. Thanks, Mike.
Well, great to be here today, and many might know CentralNic more as a domain name registrar and registry business, which we have been almost exclusively until late 2019. But today, our online marketing division represents like 80% of it, which just shows that how great monetizing traffic is as a business. And so here we have our two main products, Parking Tool for domain parking and Tonic for the referral traffic that, that Greg mentioned. And when I was first involved into domain parking, being the managing director of Name Drive, some might still remember that name, some 12 years back, we were telling guys, the main parking is dead, but I can just tell you, 2023 is still live and kicking. And and still today, Google PPC is a very valid channel to monetize traffic. And but I first leave it to my peers on this panel to also introduce themselves before we can dive into.
Thanks, Michael. David, where this is going with you at the moment, Above?
So, Above is growing substantially. I think everyone on this panel has had a similar type of growth. Focus is, for our company, we've got two sides. Above is the domain monetization side of the platform, and Trillion is the sales side, being able to sell traffic to actually grow. So from our perspective, the domain traffic, even though the Google CPCs have gone down, especially last year, which has been quite noticeable by most domain portfolio owners. However, the demand for that traffic is still there.
the same.
Before we go onto the new age of monetization, let's think about for a minute what's happening with the traditional parking, organic parking, what's been happening with prices, what are we looking at for the future. You know, we don't want to get, you know, throwing the baby out of the bathwater here when it comes to organic traffic. There's a lot of people, and we certainly are heavily focused on organic stuff. And I think that many people in this room would be interested to know, perhaps David, with you, what are your views on where it's headed, where it's at?
Sure. From my perspective, traditional parking, and I think if you know the players in this space, including Gregg, myself, and quite a few others, we see there's at least over 100,000 domain names that are registered purely for the traffic purposes every month. Every single month. Some would actually say it could be even a bit more. I think.
Well, I can tell you, we have a domain harvesting business, and we registered more than 30,000.
Yeah, we do. We do over 30,000.
That's a small month. So that's all it's for.
Yeah. So there is there's still a big demand for it. There's still domain names that get a lot of time in traffic that are worth trying to secure and to then monetize. Yes, naturally there's domain names that don't make as much as they used to in the good old days. But unfortunately, there's only one player in the space, Google, that's paying the VCs. They're not paying as much as they used to. So what we are all sort of forced to do is actually reinvent a little and change direction. So instead of just sending all the traffic to Google, we do now send a lot of traffic to direct advertisers, to affiliate networks, lead gen offer platforms, just to maximize the actual traffic and the outreach.
Well, I don't know whether many in this room can remember the days when we lived in the fear that Google was going to switch off. And we've, evolved the product to suit their ever-changing requirements at Google, but also finding ways and means of creatively enriching the domain owner in ways that perhaps beyond the grasp of Google. And that's where we start to see CPA pretty big. We start to see the other forms of affiliate. Zero stuff. And that's still a very heavy component of organic traffic.
Yeah.
What about you, Richard? Where do you see these heading?
They are still really useful traffic sources. So target traffic it used to be very good, and it's still good. And if we don't exaggerate, but that's more or less the normal advice for life. If it's too good, it's too good. So if you scale it slowly, and if you use it in a good way and in a appropriate way, then it will stay for a pretty long time. I won't say for a year, for 10 years, or for 15 years, but as long as Google is one example, but Bing, Yahoo, they're all the lead gen companies, as long as they are turning traffic into sales, into leads. There's a constant demand for good quality traffic, so I don't see any reason why it should die instantly.
Yeah, I should agree. I think that normal main traffic is going to be around for a long time. We've seen all of these things kind of go in the space that have surprised us to some extent. In other cases, we're a bit disappointed, but the fresh run of it, the referral traffic is starting to gain not only what I would call acceptance, but encouragement from the likes of Google. And perhaps on that note, I can refer to you, Mike. You've read hot from a Google meeting, I understand. I know you can't say a word that went on there, but give an impression on what somebody else thought.
Of course, what happens as a partner day stays as a partner day, but to put it more general, I don't see that Google will stop domain parking within this decade. And why is that? Because search is high intent marketing. the guy wants to go to Miami, and it must be cheap. And there are very few marketing tools that actually provide you with that kind of intent. And the same applies to domain names. If someone enters bicycle.com, that person quite likely wants to buy a bicycle, rent a bicycle, or repair a bicycle. So it's also something that is very high intent and perfectly matches that good value proposition. And this is why, because it's such a good match, I don't see that walking away from that at any point in time. But having said that, this also addresses another urban myth, which is like only the guys who basically filled up their domain portfolios in the 90s that actually make money here. Because there's always something new coming up. Like in 2008, no one knew what Bitcoin is. And then you had many years where you could register tons of crypto, Bitcoin, or whatever other currency terms, and still make money from it. Then during the COVID pandemic, there were also many very specific services, many domains created around it. And so there's always something new coming up. So I would really recommend to stay vigilant, look out for trends, and then you can still, in 2023, still build a high-performing domain portfolio from scratch.
Right, so, you know, as we move into the search app side of things, where do you see that? Is Google really, did you get the feeling that this meeting, is that actually encouraging it? I mean, we all lived in fear of, blocks and ways and means of Google clawing back and all sorts of ways of reducing the surge in perhaps the last 5 years. Now it seems to me, I mean, you feel that there's actually a warm glow underneath and actually encouraging.
Right. And I think there are two points that I would like to make. The first is it shows how performant domain parking is, because in the end, the existence of search app is just the proof that park domain is so performant in turning your traffic into profits that you can actually buy traffic from other sources and run it to the park domain name and still make money from it, which already shows that just what a great tool domain parking still is in 2023. And then again, coming back to the fear, why would Google put a stop to this? In the end, what people in this room and industry has created is a tool to convert up the funnel traffic, so where you have no intent, like on social media or news websites, and through the two clicks that you do in the search app process, basically to understand and microsegment these customers so that you can comfortably and confidently drive them into high intent search campaigns, thereby helping Google pretty much protecting its status as the apex predator in online marketing, because this way traffic that is on non-Google properties like TikTok, Facebook, the Google outbrain, and make it available to the advertisers who still see Google as the best place to put their money.
Well, I think that the likes of a public company like CentralNic, they can then stand up publicly and say, 80% of our profit is coming from search app, is great validation that it's both acceptable, legal, and approved form of monetization, which is something that is, we've always thought was the case, but it's never been out in the open, and I think that's, to me, is a great step forward in understanding what we can do as domain owners with our traffic in a legal sense, what we can do in terms of search traffic and how we disperse that traffic.
But what I'm finding is that there's a big shift now for domain investors. Rather than just only looking at which domain names to register, they're now also looking at, well, what other media traffic can we secure? Am I going to start doing Facebook advertising, TikTok advertising? And effectively,
it's a new setup, but it's just shifting it a little bit. And there is a constant demand for good high quality traffic. And as you said, it's legal. It's still good. And now maybe there's a shift of acceptance a little bit more. Before that, nobody was really openly speaking about it. But now, you need somebody to for your product. So why not book it? So when I talk to my kids, they're looking something.
Your kids are looking at your staff or your children.
My children. So when I speak to my children and they're looking something up in Google, they type something in and the first thing they click on it. I said, it's paid. They said, so it doesn't matter. It's a good hit for me. So it's a fit. So that's what I was looking for. So Google is also delivering not bad ads. So it's working. They don't make money with the everything below, so they're making money with ads. That's a fact for the last 20 years.
Okay, so what would be your advice, or your to respond? Would your advice to people that are listening today as to how they might get into this new, now approved form of monetization?
So, as I mentioned before, we have our specific platform. So basically in 2019, we took a divide between parking tool, which was aimed at the classical domain parking, and Tonic, a dedicated platform aiming at this as a search hub business. And the best step to get involved here is to talk to one of our customer reps, which are plenty around here, who can actually explain to you exactly how it works, what kind of compliance guidelines you have to look for, how your ads can actually look, so there's certain limitations, so you can't make any promises that are unrealistic to fulfill, so you can't promise that something is for free and then it's not, or you can't promise that it's being the government subsidized and then it's not. But within in the end, it's only a few rules that you really need to take serious, and these rules are there for the good of the entire industry, because Google is so successful because people know that if they put down $1 million check to Google, they also get $1 million worth of traffic on spam. And this is why it's so important for us as an industry to help them keep the space clean and follow their rules, which are simply for the better of the online advertising market as a whole. So that's on the search arm part, and then for the domain part, as I mentioned, stay vigilant, see whether the new keyword trends coming up, some like the next big thing after crypto, start buying domain names in the city sphere very early on, and then enjoy the type of traffic following suit.
And what do you see as the barriers for new people that want to get into it? I mean, it's a different dynamic to standard parking.
So there's, well, the barriers for the standard parking is like knowing the trends and getting early. That's a big challenge because a lot of us already looking at trends and already have automated search trends that might matter. But when it comes to search out, the biggest barrier is cash. To buy traffic, reporting and technology. I mean, there are a lot of tools out there and platforms that will assist with that. But knowing what traffic and converts, that's also hard. You could potentially spend hundreds of thousands of dollars and not make a whole lot back if you don't do your research correctly. You need to be prepared, and that does take a little while to learn.
We have a small search out. We started with two guys who just wanted to do it, and we decided to capitalize the effort. And it's taken them about 18 months to get to the point where they're making significant headway, significant funds. And I think that people not think that it's easy. People here, like Joe Higgins, I know, would attest to the fact that it's, you know, there's a lot of people that try and fail in the art department, and I think that I'm invested in these guys and they're doing quite well, but it's still fickle, and it's a higher risk than standard domain investing. Yeah. What are your views on that?
Nobody said it's easy, so if it's easy, everybody will do it, and then it's the hype, and that will just explode. So sustainable business. So you need passion. You need, like Michael said, have a sniff on the new trends. So that's what domainers are since the beginning. That they are ahead of most of the trends because they were registering all the domains. And I still believe in good domain names. If can't monetize the traffic, but the domain name is still good, you can sell the domain. So that's also a side part of it. And from the user experience part, yes, parking is working good, but the content part will get more and more attention. Now we have all these AI created content, so that will appear, and you always need a good domain for that. So you always need a trustworthy domain top of it, where you as a user see it and then, yeah, I trust that domain, I click on it. So, but think about yourself, how you use it, is it sustainable, will you trust it, is the ad showing, is it, will you really click on it, or it's a dodgy thing? So, advice for use, for newbies here in the room, it's not a spike, so it's slowly growing, but it's a good growing sustainable business.
So generally speaking, we're seeing this as a trend that it's a trend that is going to be a relatively permanent part of our future, and it's one that does have very different dynamics to going and buying the main parking, and therefore where can people get advice? Who can you go to that can sort of say, we used to have, like side, they was giving us lessons on how to do this with domain or whatever, but who's giving advice in this emerging area, legitimized area of monetization? Anybody got some answers to that?
Well, as I said before, you need someone who you trust, which could, for example, be your contact in Sedo parking crew would be like your advisors, really teaching you the basic rules, how it works, who might advise you how to set up your account on Facebook or TikTok to actually place your ads, some rules how to create how to do the creatives, rules around ad titles for your ads. And but then at the end of the day, other than domain parking, where you only cost this requirement domain and paying renewal fees, here we need to double down and put some money at risk. And maybe on day one, you will not get 100% of the money back. But if you do it right, it's of course fantastic because you can basically scale it pretty much without limit. It's like feeding the world out of one flower pot, so we don't basically have just one domain name, drive enough traffic to it, generate really very serious revenue from it, which is one unlikely, that's sort of lucky hit in the main part.
I suppose the reason you can scale, Gregg, keep on scaling, is there is so much traffic on this machine. It's an untapped opportunity. There's just so much available that you can simply.
So Voss mentioned that you need passion to go into this, you need huevos for sure. And another thing is that we discovered that you really need to be right across is your data collection and your regular review, because you've got sometimes minutes to be making decisions. And it's like running a, in many respects, a share portfolio on a moving market. And the whole art space is moving the whole time, and you need to be right assess and make good decisions with respect to profitability or to actually, you know, quit a campaign.
You got to know your tech. As you said, you got to know your data. You got to collect data. And I'm still surprised that there is one and all tech solution out there. So the human being as a media buyer still does, from my experience, still does the best job. Maybe different experience levels or why they are passionate or what they're doing differently, but the fully automated media buying suite or machine, to my knowledge, doesn't really exist. So there are certain tools you can combine and you can plug in together. You can use different traffic sources. You can use different monetization forms. You can have lead gen. You can have feeds in there. Google, Yahoo, whosoever. You can buy traffic from the answers. So there are different ways of plugging all this together. But maybe an advice for somebody or a wish for somebody to invent something completely automated that would cause a lot of unemployment in the media buying team.
Well, AI is threatening all those sort of jobs,
right.
And the longer this trend goes, and the more data that's collected, the more useful the AI intervention will be in buying media or the other manual components of search engine. Now, sir, I just wonder if we've got time for a question that you would like to ask.
Essentially, you know more than they do. So, like, you need some real fucking intelligence for the media buying to be effective. Otherwise, you're bidding against the same people and in the same playing field. So, that's good news, because otherwise, Gregg would just already worked out that AI.
The AI is going to invade these spaces to some extent. Doesn't mean everything is going to be totally automated, but there's so much evidence now in so many aspects of what we do that AI has, for the last 2 years, been quietly helping us. Now it's sort of exploding and everyone's doing it. You're right, at the end of the day, the final decision is needing a human in most cases, still. But even those will be changing, like automated cars, you know?
They were not on the same platform. Have to do something extra to rise above and cost time. It's also the supply and demand, just like on our platform, right? You have to do something more. If you just do exactly what the other bidders are doing on that traffic, on Trellian, wherever it is, you're just going to get one fraction of the traffic if you're lucky. And at the end of the day, you always have to add more than you take from the landscape. And that's the difference between getting in the way of someone else's money and having a sustainable business, is to have some value that isn't in an algorithm.
Right, thanks, Nancy. Anybody else got a question? And then we have a microphone at the back. question because I have the data myself.
Is there a tool that you can recommend before you purchase a domain name or register a domain name and tell what traffic you had in the past?
There are a few tools out there, but none of them are going to be very accurate. But I think the most accurate tool for that would be SimilarWeb. So if you go to SimilarWeb.com, if it was a former site, it will actually have some information about that domain. It doesn't report on really low traffic names, so you can always use that as a guide as well, that it didn't qualify. SimilarWeb have a panel of over 10 million users on one panel, and about 100 million other users that they monitor what they do online. And what that gives them access to is the user path data, so they can see all the traffic that goes through those domain names from those panel users, and that gives you an indication of the traffic profile of each domain.
So it's the marketing, everybody's accelerating it, so no precise tool.
All the people on the table have some components that they can add to the mix in terms of assisting people that are seriously interested.
There used to be other tools out there, like Alexa used to give you a little bit of information. There's other SEO type of tools that try to predict, but that's prediction models. But I always prefer the single one, which is actually based on user path data. Access to that data, they do have a free tool, so you can go online and start looking at some limited number, but if you want to utilize access to that, it becomes costly. We're looking at minimum $10,000 a year for your base subscription, and if you want API access, that gives you that's a lot more expensive.
Yeah, we're subscribers of SimilarWeb, we consider them one of our valuable components to what we do.
Well, I would actually want to connect this with the point on AI. In the end, what the buffer is built is already ready for AI in the form of automated A/B testing. So rather than trying to predict from some data which might be precise or not, to come to one deterministic outcome, you basically just run all the domains past all the options that you have and then stick it with deterministic test results, which is simply an early form of artificial intelligence.
Any other questions before we move on? Yes. But just wait till we have a microphone so we don't have to repeat it. There we go. Thank you.
So just the host of a crashing the party, but I was wondering about domain leasing. Do you see any potential in there? We come across lots of websites from hosting companies that just churn off people no longer interested in doing their own business. Is there a potential for leasing the needs and monetizing it in a way that's profitable?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, that's where most of the public domain names come from that have traffic. There are majority of them are expired domain names.
I was talking about leasing the actual domain name, not just
leasing.
Yeah.
Is there somebody who's leasing or just leasing because the traffic will die?
So if you're a hosting company in that perspective, do you mean? So if you're a hosting company and you have customers that fail to renew, then yes, you can make a partnership with companies like us above also go, and we can then help you monetize that traffic while that domain name is expired. And then if they renew it, it just resumes business.
Whether it's bought or leased is immaterial to that flow of the traffic.
Yeah.
It's about more profit.
Yeah.
Any more questions? Okay. So, I guess we could turn to the creation of web pages from portfolio that could work. Because of comments, over to you with a web page or basically putting together stuff that actually attracts people.
Yeah, so that's what's if the net will be flooded by millions of created websites, if they have use or not, but nothing wrong with having a good domain name with a good with an authority, let's say headache.com. Why should you maneuver through so many hundred pages if you want to know something about headaches or how to get rid of it? So why not setting up a web page just for or against headaches? And you don't want to buy dog food on that, so straightforward to the
Well, on that point of headaches, we're going to give out a bit of a problem if you don't stop, because we've run out of time. I want to thank our audience for being so attentive and for the questions we had, and Michael, David, and Christian for